Larry and I have been in Florida for a few days now. The pros. It's not cold, there's no snow, and this house is just amazing. For the cons, I'm away from my family, and the humidity, it's not good for my hair. Huge con. So listen, I don't want any wisecracks that my hair looks good, flat. So today I'm visiting a salon to try to figure out how I can do my hair, because apparently the way I like to wear my hair with hairspray is a huge no-no in Florida. So this is the thing. I feel like I lost my personality without my height and my hair. Bottom line, if my hair isn't blonde and I don't have the height, I don't feel like myself.
Andrew, this is a big determination whether we move down here or not.
Is it really?
Oh, God.
Listen, the pressure's on.
So I'm not trying to put any pressure on you, but there's some pressure on you.
I mean, look, there are other factors. Larry's saying it's all about my hair. I live right next door to my parents.
But hair is so important.
It is.
You know, your look is so important.
Don't you see how they? I live right next door to my parents and my hair. Those are the two things that are holding me back from moving to Florida.
Know what I'm doing right now?
Yeah.
Hot, and now I'm hitting it with cold air. This helps smooth it out some
way. Hot, cold.
Hot, cold.
See, I got a comb over. Hi, how are you? Good. Let me ask you something. I'm a medium, which means that I'm able to connect with people that have crossed over.
Okay.
Who is the mother figure for you that's departed?
My mom.
Okay. Did your mom like to yell, or did she have a loud voice?
Big mouth.
Oh, because she's yelling at me, and I'm like, why are you yelling at me?
Big mouth, yes, very. My name is Andrea. My mother was a yeller. She was very outspoken. She told you what she thought. She didn't hold many things back, and she was a good person.
And now, your mom also tells me, though, that things happened very quickly, though, with her departure.
Yes.
I don't know if she didn't feel well and didn't take it serious that she didn't feel well. So your mom wants you to know that she takes responsibility, but more importantly, that she's sorry. And she said, I want my daughter to know that she was always there for me. Your mother said no regrets.
My mother passed away 3 years ago from intestinal problems. She got hospitalized on a trip in New York to see my other sister. Because my mom lived with us, every time my mom got any inkling of a sickness, I would take her straight to the doctor. But when she got sick up in New York, she didn't take it as seriously as she should have. It's the fact that my mom didn't want me to have regrets that I wasn't there is huge, because that's, you know, my mom told you what she thought, but she didn't always tell you, I made a mistake or I'm sorry.
Let me ask you, who's the young male that's departed?
Oh, my brother.
So know that your mom is bringing forward your brother, and you know
yes.
that the souls are together.
Yes.
Remember years ago when you would have pictures and then they used to copper the shoes?
Yes, yes.
Do you have your brother's
yes.
baby shoes coppered?
Yes. Yes.
Is that amazing?
My brother. My brother was fantastic. He was loving and carefree, and he was just an amazing person. My brother died 23 years ago from HIV, AIDS.
And your brother says, I've never left you, and you know that. You've been feeling me all these years. You see me, you feel me. He says, and I will never leave. My soul will always be with you, and I do watch over your children as you've prayed for us to do.
To know that my two children are being watched over by my brother, for her to validate that to me, it just really confirmed what, of course, you always hope.
Thank you.
I feel fantastic right now. I really do.
But wait, how do you connect with the teeth? Did someone have false teeth or?
Oh, my mom did.
She goes, look, my teeth don't come out anymore.
She did, because when I had her at the hospital, the first thing she said to me is, Andrea, make sure my teeth are good.
Amazing, just amazing.
No blow dryer will stop you from doing a reading.
Clearly, nothing stops spirit. Not even 500 hair dryers blowing at one time.
Doesn't it feel nice not for your hair to be all stiff and sticky?
Do I look Floridian?
Yeah, definitely.
Listen, I'm very happy with the way my hair came out.
Oh, it's so nice meeting you.
But I don't feel like myself.
Bottom line is, you don't need hairspray.
Hun, if you know how I feel. If I give up my hairspray and my height on my hair, I feel like I'm giving up my personality. And let's face it, you fell in love with my personality and my hair.
And your hair. Yeah, I did.
So I am not taking any chances of you falling out of love with me. So my hair is staying the way that it is, and I'm using hairspray. The great thing about being in Florida is that I can continue to work and see clients. So today, I'm in Fort Lauderdale for the first time ever surprising a couple with a private reading. I am double nervous. The stakes are higher because we have to worry about surprising two people, Adele and Yasi. Adele's sister set this whole thing up. She had to convince both of them to leave work early.
We're Adele's sisters. I'm Lorraine, and this is my other sister, Rochelle.
I called Adele and told her I had something very important to talk to her and Yasi about.
Okay, so this is it.
And told her I could not talk to her on the phone. I'll be there at 3. Can you be there at 3? I need to talk to you both.
First knock and talk for a couple.
Adele and Yasi need this reading so much. They have been through a lot.
And this reading will give them some comfort.
Adele? Hi!
Oh my God!
Come on out! Come on out! Hi! Do you know who I am? I came all the way from Long Island to surprise you!
Oh my God!
And where's Yasi?
I can't believe you're going to see me.
Yasi, come on out. Come join the party.
To see her at the bottom of our stairs, outside our house? I couldn't get my head around it.
Up close and personal, right here.
I just can't get my head around it that we're so blessed that she's here with us. Doesn't happen like that for us.
Not for us.
Just things don't happen like that.
No. They lied to us.
I can't believe
it. Who lied to you?
The sisters.
Tell them to come out here.
I'm so grateful to my sisters for doing this. It's unbelievable how they kept the secret. They can't keep a secret between them.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
You're so fine. Thank you. We're a very, very, very close family. And what happened to us?
That's all you have to say.
What happened to us? Just splintered our whole life.
Yeah.
Have you guys ever been to a medium before?
Once.
Okay. So this is going to be different because you're going to be different the time of your grieving. Parents are not supposed to bury their children. From the moment I saw you, that's all I hear. You lost your son?
Yes.
This for you is about anger. For your wife, it's about peace.
It's true.
It's true.
It's so true. Our son Warren passed.
I'm angry that we were best friends and I didn't get a chance to say goodbye to him.
The biggest thing as a parent is he okay? Is he at peace?
Your son says you honor me every day.
I talk to him every day going to work.
He shows me you treasure all these little pieces of paper with his handwriting on it.
God, we have them on the fridge.
And you look at them and you stare at them.